Have you ever wondered, why do we keep change and flip whenever we divide by a fraction? What do I mean? Let me show you. Let's take a look at 2 over 7 divided by 3 over 5. And here we go. Keep means we keep the first fraction, so we have 2 over 7. Change means we are going to change the division to a multiplication. And then flip means we are going to flip the second fraction. So instead of 3 over 5, we will have 5 over 3. And now we can just multiply these two fractions. And to do so, we just need to multiply the numerators. 2 times 5, we get 10. And then over, and we multiply the denominators. 7 times 3, we get 21. And that's the answer. And we do this all the time. But why does this work? Well, let me explain. But let me show you a regular division with whole numbers first. So let's take a look at 8 divided by 2. And I would like to tell you, once we get to algebra, we will not see the division symbol anymore, because we would like to write this into the fraction form. And to do so, we keep the first number on the top. The division symbol becomes the fraction bar, and then the second number goes on the bottom, like this. 8 over 2, 2 goes into 8 4 times, and that's the answer. Done. But keep this in mind, because now let's go back to number 1 and use the same idea. So we have 2 over 7 divided by 3 over 5. By this, we are going to keep the first fraction on the top, so this right here becomes 2 over 7, and the division symbol becomes a fraction bar. We have a fraction bar already, I know. Let's have another one and make it bigger. And then for the second number, which is this fraction, it goes to the bottom. We have 3 over 5. I know I just made this worse, right? I did. Because this is called complex fraction. We have one little fraction, two little fractions inside of a big one. But it's okay, because we can fix this. How? If we can somehow make the bottom to be 1, then we don't have complex fraction anymore, because over 1 doesn't matter. So here we have 3 over 5. How can we make that into a 1 though? Well, the answer is, let's multiply by its reciprocal, namely 5 over 3. How does this work? Well, when we multiply, of course we can cross cancel. 3 and 3 cancel, 5 and 5 cancel, and the bottom is just 1. And remember, whatever you do to the bottom, you do the same thing on the top. So we multiply by, 5 over 3 on the top, as well, just like that. This is why. And of course, now you can work that out, and you will get 10 over 21. That's it.